the physical plant has changed, but the mission and the sense of community have not changed. We really are very student focused here, and being a small college or university now, you know, we really care about our students and we know our students, and that's what's kept me here this long. So our program is called medical imaging, and the core of that is the radiography or general x-ray curriculum. And so, but what makes us different than other schools is that we are a four-year baccalaureate program, and there are many associate degree programs in radiologic technology, and there are several baccalaureate programs that are what I call 2+2s, 2 years of core classes and 2 years of radiologic technology. We are a truly integrated four-year program, and what that means is that we have the students for the entire time. They start in their medical imaging classes in their freshman year, and they have combined core classes and imaging classes throughout the 4 years that they're here. The reason students want to come here is for that fourth year. And in our fourth year, our students are able to specialize in one of the areas of imaging. So they can do an internship in computed tomography, mammography, cardiac catheterization, any of those specialty areas that fall within medical imaging. We have five full-time faculty that teach in the different levels of the program, and we all hold the certifications in radiography, in the main area, and many of us have additional certifications. Myself, I have certifications in cardiovascular imaging, computed tomography, vascular interventional. We start clinical rotations in the sophomore spring. So it's much earlier than you can see in a lot of other programs. So they have hands-on clinical rotations in 7 semesters. So they start out in clinic one in a general radiology department in a hospital, 2 days a week in the hospital, 3 days a week here on campus with classes, and of course our laboratory facilities there. Before we even get to the clinic, they have the sophomore fall where they have several laboratory classes here on campus where they learn how to do radiographic procedures and positioning, where they learn how to take exposures. We have an energized lab that we use for actually, they're able to take x-rays on these phantoms that simulate, you know, a human. And so they get a lot of hands-on before they get to clinic in the sophomore fall, and then in the sophomore spring, they're actually in the hospitals. When they are in clinic, they're not just out there on their own. You know, we have qualified radiologic technology educators that are with them while they're in the clinic. So we have some of our students that are dual enrolled in medical imaging and sonography. And so they are with us for the first 4 years, and they start taking sonography classes in their senior year along with their internship area. And they actually can graduate in May of their fourth year from the radiologic technology program, or medical imaging program, continue for 9 months, and then be certified in sonography as well. We have had, and very proud of this, we have had 100% job placement rate for the last 5 years. So one of the areas I didn't mention in the internship is radiation therapy. And so several of our students choose an internship in radiation therapy in their senior year, but then they need to go on to school for one more year to become a radiation therapist. And that is a very difficult program to get into. Most of the schools only take 2 or 3 students a year. We have 100% placement of our radiation therapy graduates into those programs. We look for students that are strong in the sciences and strong in math, particularly. If I was a high school junior, I would make sure that in my senior year I was taking physics, because we have quite a, heavy physics based curriculum. So they need to be strong in math, strong in sciences. Anatomy and physiology is another good class to take in high school to prepare them for when they get here, because their freshman year, they're going to be in anatomy and physiology, and that's very important. What we do in medical imaging is look at anatomy all day long. We are the experts on anatomy, and we need to be able to show the doctors and the surgeons what it is that they're going for. When they graduate, they will be sitting for their national exam in first radiography. Our national certifying agency is called the American Registry of Radiologic Technologists. So everything they learn from the time they walk in the door until the time they graduate, they need to remember and be able to pass a national exam. We do prepare them for that national exam, and we do have specific courses and programs that they need to do in their senior year to prepare them to take the radiography boards. We do have a very high pass rate, and in the 30 years I've been here, almost every single time we have 100% pass rate. So we've had a very few students who have had to take it the second time. They can take advanced level exams in mammography and MRI and CT and cardiovascular, and we get them ready for that. Most of our students do walk out the door into jobs in the specialty areas. We believe in multi-credentialing, and a lot of the hospitals want somebody that can do more than one thing. So you could work 2 days in radiography and 3 days in CT or something like that. So that makes them very marketable. In the state of Pennsylvania, right now, the average salary for the technologists that were last reported was, $56,000 a year. And then as you specialize, it goes up. So the more credentials that you have, the higher the salary ranges are. I would recommend that anybody that wants to go into radiologic technology or any of the imaging fields would make sure that they were going to an accredited program, and that our accrediting agency is the Joint Review Commission on Education in Radiologic Technology. And on their website, they actually post the program completion rates, the pass rates, and have links to information regarding the accreditation status of the college or university that they're looking into. One of the things that I caution, because I do see as different, is the amount of clinical supervision. Okay, so many places they send you out into the hospitals, and then maybe someone from the college comes to visit you once a semester and check on your progress. And we don't do that. So when our students are out there, so are we, and so we get to work alongside of them. If you are accepted into this program, we find your clinical sites. We assign the clinical sites, and they're all within an hour of the campus. Here at Misericordia, we have a club called the Medical Imaging Club that is a service-oriented club. And as a matter of fact, I'm proud to say that last year, our club won Outstanding Academic Organization here at the university. And that is because of the amount of hours of service that our students provide. The other thing that we have besides the MI club is we have a mentoring program. So we pair up the underclassmen with the upperclassmen. We can honestly say that we know that our students love us, and they love our major, and they love this campus, And you know, the one we scored the highest in was sense of belonging to the major. And that really, you know, means a lot to the faculty that our students feel that way about us.